Good morning, my ambidextrous wombats. I trust this day finds you well. Today, we will be indulging ourselves in the challenges presented by such things as horses, bears, and trees. Why trees? Simple. Because trees are bastards. I've even tried to keep this short, but I do need to tell you this process has caveats, and it is those caveats I will share with you. And to save a C, I will also admit that nothing I do with this workflow you are looking at can make me insert a bear into this scene. Why? Well, that isn't such a simple answer, but I will answer it as best I can. The reason I cannot insert a bear into this scene, and I did try, as you will see shortly, is because it is the right approach to take. That is, this is it the right setup workflow. I will of course do a video very soon on how to replace subjects in videos, because I notice a lot of people asking for it, and if you want to look at that immediately, then go to my Footprints in Eternity video and download the 18 workflows I used to make that short narrative noir. In there you will find a VACE 2.1 workflow for swapping out characters. Alternatively, I will be testing VACE 2.2 dual model methods to achieve those results, but that is a little way down the road. For now, I would recommend Wanimate, and I do have a video on that, which is the one I'm compositing I put out a few days ago. But today we will do at least two things. Firstly, we will use Inpainting to fix shadow of a horse that is missing. Then we will attempt to insert a bear into this scene, unsuccessfully, and I will explain why as we try. And finally, if I have time, I will show this method used on a flying over the treetops camera shots to fix bastard walking trees, roaming campfire smoke, and jarring seams caused by an extended video I did previously. So now I've explained what I plan to do, let's see how much we can get done in the time allowed. We'll begin by discussing the workflow, and this workflow is the same basic workflow as I shared in my FFLF video using WAN 2.2 dual model setup, but I have ripped the input images out of it and added in nodes to help me insert masks. And yes, if you watched VACE Part 1 video, it is pretty much the exact same workflow I used there. But I will share this separately just for those that didn't watch that first video and don't plan to. So let's quickly go through what is in this workflow. Firstly, we have the dual WAN 2.2 and VACE 2.2 model and module setup, high noise and low noise. And I won't go into details on that. You can of course use any goth model types you like here. You can even use merge VACE and WAN models. I just find the FPH EE5M2 and separate VACE module to be superior for my 3060 RTX 12GB VRAM card. And here is a quick screenshot to show you that yes, I have 19GB of files in the FP8 E5M2 model and module setup, and yet it doesn't fill up my VRAM at all, and
don't believe the myth that file sizes must match VRAM size. It's not the size that counts, it is what you do with it.
But don't believe women when they say that either, it's the size that counts. Trust me. And moving swiftly on, as I prepare to talk you through this Inpainting workflow, I realise I have just lied to you. Not about women and whether size matters, but about this workflow. It isn't quite the same as the one I shared in part 1. I have removed the nodes I used in part 1, and instead done this by applying the masks to videos using Shotcut. The reason I did this was because I wanted to test targeting a portion of the video without masking out the entire frame. And that is what we are looking at here in the masking section of this workflow. Here we have the preview coming from 81 frames of horse video I showed you previously, where the shadow beneath the horse is missing. And here we have the targeted masking, where you can't see it, but I have added grey to the area we are wishing to add shadow, but you can see the additional mask that then restricts our focus in the white and black masking. Two things are happening here. Firstly, we are targeting the small white area, and secondly, we are only targeting it for part of the video, not all of it. There are many caveats to discuss about this method, and I will as we get on, but it does work, as you will see shortly. But first, let us discuss how I got to this point, and to do that, I used Shotcut.
You could use anything you like, but Shotcut is open source. And rather a little chap for quick editing.
As I complicate matters, I decided to make both masks at the same time, in the one Shotcut file, which is what you are seeing here. And I will switch in and out the two videos, then play them for you as examples so you can see what is going on. We must make two kind of masks for VACE, and I think this is sometimes a little confusing. We need a grey mask applied to the video itself. Yeah. That is, the images receive a middle grey masking, and that could be targeted or could be the entire frame. But you also need the white and black masking, which is the masking itself. And it is binary, in that VACE will replace anything that is white and will ignore anything that is black. That could be targeting inside a frame or the entire frame itself. And VACE needs both, the white and black mask to tell it what to ignore, and the middle grey mask to be sure it is targeting the image. In our case, I will be using the prompt to define what I want done, and this is where one of those caveats comes in. This workflow works with this approach, using a prompt to target the change we want to see. And yes, you can write put a bear in the prompt, but it won't do it. And I have tried. And this is one caveat I will discuss shortly. So talking you through what is going on in this workflow, you now understand we need two mask types. The grey masking of the area where we plan to add a shadow beneath the horse, and also the white and black masking targeting the exact same area. As you can see here, I am starting the mask targeting at frame number 9. I am putting that info in three places: the start index of the replace images in batch node, and in both videos to set the first 9 frames to be skipped. I do this because the first 9 frames of the original 81 frame video need to be left completely alone. You will notice I have also added a frame cap to both masking videos at 57 frames, because that is how many frames I wish to target before once again we leave the rest of the original frames alone, and I use all the previews to tell the I am getting the maths right. So it seems this will work how I want it to. Next I add in my prompt, after that I decide on resolution, and in this case for speed I am going to only make it 480p in 81 frames at 16 frames per second, and here is the result. The first thing to notice is the shadow has been fixed. Voila! The second thing to notice is yet another caveat within painting in general. As I play this through, you can see the contrast and quality level change at frame 9 and change back again 57 frames later. I did that partly to show the issue within painting. This really comes from the VAE decode and encoding as much as from anything else. It is a known problem and why it's difficult to extend videos without suffering quality loss. There are three approaches to mitigate the problem. One is working in latent space, and I have a video about that. The second is using compositing, and I have a video about that too. And the third is using detailer or oscaling, and I have a video about that as well. All work, but compositing is probably the best and necessary in order to retain consistent characters, but we are digressing away from the topic of this video. So, now it is time to show you the problems of trying to shove a bear into this scene using this workflow approach, and why it doesn't work. I should have time at the end to then show you how to use this workflow to fix the issue I mentioned at the start with morphing trees, roaming campfires, and jarring seams of extended videos, but first, get the bear. We are at 6 minutes, so I will try to keep this brief. First, I tried masking out a bunch of frames in the middle of my horse video, using grey input for the entire frame and white for the entire frame in the masking. I then shoved a bear in the reference image slot, which is the correct approach. Just normally it needs more than this, but I wanted to see what I would get doing this. I got nothing. Not to be deterred, I used some trusty old method to remove the background from my bear adder and adding some white padding. Maybe that would sort it. I also added bear runs around in the prompt, but I left the full frame grey masking and full frame white masking in place and ran it again. Surely this would give me some bear action. I got nothing, but it was my first barbecue and was my first bear, and if there is one thing I have learnt in this game, it is that we must be persistent until all avenues have been explored, and either we get bear or we get arrested. Hang on, there was another time. When faced with insurmountable odds regarding bears, horse, bastard trees, or a variety of other vermin, the trick is to establish dominance, and so I took you to the next level, pushed through the glass ceiling, the change I want to see, and countless other mindless tropes. And before I get carried away, which admittedly is happening, I applied all my worldly knowledge to intercept this goddamn bear and shove the fucker into my scene. Oops, can I say that? So I ripped out the background, added in the grey frame, masked out the goddamn bear, and blended him right into that frame, then rammed that damn bear where the sun don't shine. And what did I get? Well, admittedly, I got a bear, but it wasn't quite what I wanted. As I said, this is my first barbecue, and this is my first bear. And if there's one thing I have learned when persistence doesn't work, is to give up before it drives you mad. So I gave up, mostly because I knew this wasn't the right way to approach it, but it had been worth a punt, and I will show you how to do it in a future video. But as always, from my mistakes come my greatest lessons. Yes, that is how I reframe these experiences to calm myself into believing I did a great thing after all. So, what do we learn here? Well, many things, but to summarize, I would say this isn't the right way to shove a new thing into your shot. And what that means in practical terms is this: use this in-painting workflow to fix things, but don't try to use it to add new things into existing scenes. I didn't try removing all the frames and prompting for bears, but I think the VACE is seeing the start frames and the end frames, and then it knows that we have a horse trotting across the scene. Mask out areas requiring shadows, no problem, it will give them AE, but ask for a random new thing, and even show it a picture, but it won't be enough for VACE to let go of the fact it saw the start and end frames, and doesn't want to add new stuff in unless it makes sense to it. This is, of course, my conjecture. But to finish up, and because adding a shadow into a bit of grass below a horse is hardly life-changing stuff, and because all I have shown you other than this is abject bear failure and possibly a lot of my personal issues, I will now show you how I use the previous workflow and the one I will share with you to fix a variety of things, from walking trees to roaming campfires, and fix the jarring seams of extended videos. What we have here is part of a 32-second long extended shot that you might recall from previous videos. And observe the problems we face with it. The scene where I extended it is where you see the jarring movement as the camera gets near the clearing. Bastard trees are wandering about there in the middle right of the shot, and we have some campfire issues. In that the campfire is roaming to the left, enjoying itself immensely while winding me eat. So quite simply, these are all fixable using the workflow we have been working on throughout this video in various forms. I will add the exact workflow for this and the horse shadow fix into the download. I won't add the others, but left you shots in the video, so if you want to experiment with things, you can use those as reference.
Now I will show you how this workflow can fix many things in context of the original video, and that is what it is best for.
It does of course bring with it some problems, but none that could not be fixed with a DaVinci transition or simply a prompt.
But I will show you the result. And this was only at 480p, I didn't bother going higher as I was only doing it for the purposes of this video. But we have fixed the jarring somewhat, fixed the campfire roaming, and fixed the bastard walking trees.
Admittedly, the initial forest has been thinned out for no reason, but I think that will do for today. Next time.
Well, I need to do some project work, but I also need to test the character swapping vase method in a dual workflow. So we'll look at that. But it won't be tomorrow. Till next time then, my furry ferreted friends. Ciao, bambinos.